My name is Gloria Lum. My instrument is a cello. And I actually started playing music when I was 4, and I played the piano, and I didn't pick up the cello till I was 8. My earliest memory of playing music probably was at my piano teacher's house. And I was trying to do a very difficult rhythmic thing where you play triplets in the right hand and duples in the left, so it's kind of complicated. I think I must have been maybe 6 at the time, and she bribed me by saying if I could do this properly, she would let me play with her dog. Needless to say, I did not get a chance to play with the dog. I think playing music is probably the place where I am most like myself. I feel like I can express things that I can't in a verbal sense. I love playing with my colleagues because you get a sense of communication that really goes beyond, I think, speech. And we take cues off each other that are physical, really tiny cues when we work with a conductor. It's all pretty much without any words. And I love that. I love the fact that you can communicate through a different means than language. Music is its own language. I get great joy from playing music, intense joy. I feel very alive when I do it, and I'm always thrilled to be able to share that with my colleagues and with an audience. Originally, we were supposed to pick out instruments that we wanted to play, I think in the third grade. I had a cousin who played the flute, and I was fascinated by wind instruments, and I really wanted to play the clarinet. But my brother said to me at the time, oh, why don't you play the cello? Nobody plays the cello. And I thought, okay. So unfortunately, there isn't like a great romantic story about how I heard the sound and wanted to play it. But it is, I think, the best instrument because it really encompasses the range of the human voice. And I think because of that, it's particularly touching to play and to listen to. So I'm glad I ended up with a cello. Nothing against clarinets. I think it is very hard to learn how to play a musical instrument. And string instruments, I think, are harder than most. So it's great to be able to have something that you can go to, like a video, if you don't have access to a really great teacher, to hear from professionals how we make sound, how we approach music, how we approach the instrument, with knowing that everybody is slightly different, so what works for me may not work for you, but we try and make it so that we can let you know or kind of give you some guidelines as to how you're doing and how to basic approaches to the instrument.